With a warm hug and his hand on the shoulder of Volodymyr Zelensky, Narendra Modi sent a big message to the world on his maiden visit to the war-torn country, that India was in solidarity with Ukraine. Both world leaders looked visibly emotional as they visited a memorial in honor of Ukrainian children who have died in the last 2.5 years as a result of Russia's war. In a post in Ukrainian on X, Modi acknowledged that the conflict is especially devastating for young children. Zelensky and Modi held one-on-one and delegation-level talks for nearly 3 hours in Kiev. The focus was squarely on finding a negotiated settlement to the Russia-Ukraine conflict. Modi made it clear that India has always chosen the side of peace since the onset of the conflict.
भारत ने हो सका उतना एक मानवीय दृष्टिकोण को केंद्र में रखते हुए पूरा करने का प्रयास किया है और मैं आपको विश्वास दिलाता हूं कि मानवीय दृष्टिकोण से भी जिस प्रकार की मदद की आवश्यकता होगी भारत हमेशा हमेशा आपके साथ खड़ा रहेगा और दो कदम आगे चलेगा।
Nearly 6 weeks ago, Modi flew to Moscow to meet Russian President Vladimir Putin. It was the Indian Prime Minister's first official trip abroad after returning to power for his third consecutive term.
मुझे आपने अपने घर पर निमंत्रित किया और आज की शाम हम साथ में गप्पे मारे इसलिए आपने तय किया इस कार्यक्रम की रचना के लिए और मुझे घर पे बुलाने के लिए मैं आपका बहुत-बहुत आभार व्यक्त करता हूं।
But the visit came hours after Russian bombing killed at least 41 people in Ukraine, including at a children's hospital in Kiev, sparking a global outcry. So Modi's Moscow trip did not resonate well with the West. Zelensky was particularly critical, saying he was disappointed to see the leader of the world's largest democracy hug the world's most bloody criminal in Moscow. Ever since Russia invaded Ukraine in February 2022, India has refrained from directly criticizing Moscow, much to the annoyance of the West. India, which is the world's largest importer of arms, still buys more than 50% of its defense equipment from Russia. India has also increased its oil imports from Russia, taking advantage of cheaper prices offered by Moscow. US and its allies have often tried to pressurize India to take a clearer stand on the war, but New Delhi has stayed firm. At the end of the day, the West also sees India as a counterbalance to China and doesn't want to upset that dynamic. But the war has taken a new turn now. 2 weeks ago, Ukrainian troops launched a surprise incursion into Russia's Kursk region and have taken control of nearly 2,000 square kilometers of Russian land. Ukraine has captured more Russian land in a fortnight than Russia had captured in Ukraine in the last 8 months. This is the biggest attack on Russian soil since World War II.
Шановний пане прем'єр-міністр Моді, для нас на сьогодні це велика честь приймати в Україні в день нашого державного прапора прем'єр-міністра Індії, дружньої Індії. Це дуже символічно, тому що це історичний момент, історичний візит, це перший візит прем'єр-міністра Індії в незалежну Україну.
For Ukraine, Modi's visit is an opportunity to engage with a close ally of Moscow, something it hasn't done much since the war began. Modi is one of the very few world leaders who has maintained good ties with both Putin and Zelensky, even as the war has been dragging on. For India, Modi's visit to Ukraine also serves bigger goals. New Delhi has been increasing its engagement with Europe in the past decade, particularly in Central and Eastern Europe. And while India's boosting engagement with other countries in Europe, it also wants to keep consolidating its relationships with the Big Four, that is Britain, Italy, Germany and France. And these countries have been firmly with Ukraine in the war. New Delhi wants to play a bigger role in geopolitics, and strong relations with Europe will serve them well in the future.